A unique way to share your money among your heirs in a way that is actually fair. This story is the story of a good friend of mine, grandfather, and how he dealt with his inheritance in a very unique way. He had two sons, and each of them also had two sons. In the last half year of his life, my friend and me visited him every morning and every evening. You see, he did not want to go into a retirement home. And apart from getting ready in the morning and in the evening, he did not really need help. Now I need to explain something real quick. Back in the day, we still have mandatory service in the army for 12 months. But there was several way around it. I will only explain the most common way, since it is connected to our story. You see, instead of going to the army, you could say you refused to go to the army for ethical reasons, which was really just a formality. You simply wrote a one-page essay why you think you being in the army would violate your personal ethics, and they pretty much had to accept it. But that meant you had to go into civil service. Civil service could be any kind of job tat in a wider sense is a service to society. So these jobs range from kindergarten to retirement homes and anything in between, like hospitals, homes for the physically or mentally disabled, meals on wheels, pretty much anything you can imagine. You would be paid for that time the same amount of money you would get in the army, and have the right to certain perks like a free room, health insurance, and work clothes, etc. The same stuff any soldier gets. Plus, since soldiers get free food, you either got free food or a food allowance. I did my time in a retirement home, and it was an awesome experience. I think a job like that really widens your horizon as a young arrogant shit, and really matures you and shows you what is actually important in life. Back to the story. I was just done with my time in the retirement home, and for 1 year imply wanted to job around and make some money. Then one of my best friends comes to me and tells me he needs my help. His grandpa can no longer do everything by himself, but really only needs help in the morning to get ready and in the evening. Since I have learned how to do this from real professionals, he asks me to show him, so his grandpa does not yet have to go into a retirement home. He later admitted grandpa said he would rather kill himself than get into a nursing home, and he seemed really serious about it. He did not tell me at the time, since he did not want to pressure me into help like that, which I really appreciated. He was one of my best friends, and I really liked his grandpa. When I was younger, I did not have a grandpa, but we visited him all the time and I became his unofficial fifth grandson. So of course I said yes. The original plan was to show him for 2 to 3 weeks, and then observe him for another 2 to 3 weeks. Then he would do it on his own, but we ended up doing it together for over half a year. Then grandpa had a stroke and died within 2 days in the hospital. Days later, my friend asked me to come with him to the lawyer where the LST will would be spread. His grandfather had specifically asked that his will should be read the day before he gets buried, which is quite unusual, but not illegal as such. I asked why he answered me there, and he told me the lawyer had officially invited me, since grandpa had left me something as a thank you for my service. I was a bit embarrassed, but also happy that grandpa had thought so highly of my service. He even put me in his last will. Now my friend's dad is an entitled asshole, and the same goes for his uncle. We arrived there, and went into the room as here my friend is F. You get 3 guesses who ME is. Entitled is Ed and entitled uncle is in you. Ed, to me, why the hell are you here? I know that dad called you in just his fifth grandkid, but this is for real family. EU. I bet the little goldfinger hoped he would get some money in the will. Me. I was asked to be here by the lawyer. Take it up with him. I have no idea why I am here. Ed. If you pull something to get to his money, I will sue you so hard even your kids will still need lawyers. F. Show some respect and stop shouting. I know you two did not really give a shit about your dad. But show at least a minimum of respect. EU. How dare you talk like that to your elders, you little shit. F. You two get exactly as much respect from me as you showed your own father none. He really shouted THE last word. And it finally shut the two up. We sat down and still had to wait for the other two grandkids to arrive. The two sat right behind us. And what they talked about really made my blood boil. Apparently they had both gotten new cars, new jewelry for the wife and had planned a huge holiday. All that was paid for by credit and they had planned to pay for it with the inheritance. None of them said even a word about missing him, being sad that he died. Nothing. Only me, 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 me and money. 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 They seemed to be in competition who could spend the inheritance faster the way they planned away. The money. Then finally we were all there and Valeria read out a short letter. What I tell you here is a much shortened version. But the real thing was several pages. But it boils down to this. In recent years I more and more realized that some people in my family cared a lot more about me than others. I am especially disappointed in my two sons. But I wanted to be really fair and not biased. So I came up with a point system. Letter, phone call. 1 point plus one extra if it is very long. Visit. 2 points per hour plus 1 point per hour of travel to me and back. Helping me out with something. 3 points per hour. This is the final result over the last 3 years of my life. Ed. 8 points. EU. 10 points. You kid 1 to 150 points. You kid 2 to 133 points. F brother. 288 points. F. 7,341. Me. 5,883. My lawyer has already liquidated most of my assets except the house. Once it is sold, the money will be divided by the points. So we know what each point is worth. And then every person gets a share of the money according to his points. For about a minute you could hear a pin drop. Then both Ed and EU started shouting at the same time that they knew we would have pulled something. And this fool would never stand. Of course they tried to sue EU, his kids and Ed together. But they lost. And there was a secret clause. Not really secret. It was simply not read to us that day. So nobody realized it was in there since we all assumed everything was read to us on that day by the lawyer, in the will that if someone sues against the will, he loses his share of the inheritance. It took nearly 3 years until all the lawsuits were over. I was blown away when we finally got the money. I ain't not naming a sum, but it was way more than I felt comfortable accepting. So I wanted to give at least some of it to the other three grandkids. But my friend finally convinced me to accept by saying to me, you cared for him when he needed you, without expecting anything for it. Which makes you 10 times more his family than any of those fuckers. They got what they deserved. Lie about giving me a raise. Say goodbye to your income. Updated. Now with 100% more revenge. Sorry that it's so long. Please have patience. There is a reason why I wrote it all out like